Hi all, Will here. This week we're excited to launch the LangMem SDK, a library of utilities for helping you build agents that learn and adapt as you go. In this video, we'll show you how to add semantic memory to your agents so they can remember important facts and other information that tells them what type of content to include in their responses. Semantic memory is all about facts and knowledge. With LangMem, you can chat with your bot can save memories for later use, and then when you chat with it later, it can interact with these memories. As you can see, it remembers I'm training for a half marathon and it remembers the current plan that I have in place. With every interaction, the memory state is updated, so each memory then has additional context based on this. It now remembers that I'm dealing with tendonitis and need to have a modified training regimen. So let's create a React agent with semantic memory. We'll first review how to make an agent in LangGraph. We'll use the pre-built wrapper for concision. First, we'll install LangMem. Then we'll create the agent. We'll give the agent short-term memory in the form of checkpointing, and we'll also give it a long-term memory store. It won't have a direct connection with it yet, so it won't actually use it. Now we'll create the agent. We'll make a little wrapper just to make it more convenient to interact with. Now that we've created the agent, we can chat with it. If you continue to talk along the same thread, it'll still remember it because this is all in the conversation history. This is short-term memory that it won't retain between contexts. If we create a new thread, it won't be able to remember that information in this new conversation because it doesn't have anything that's long-term and stored between these interactions. Now it's time to add memory. We'll do so by giving our agent two tools to interact with this memory store. One is for creating memories and updating and deleting them. The other is for searching it. Whenever it needs to recall new information, it can decide to go and fetch new memories. We will update our long-term memory store by adding an indexing configuration. This tells LangGraph that anytime you save an item to the store, we will embed it with this vectorizer so that we can later search semantically over the memories. We will create our tools so the agent can interact with the memory store by providing it a namespace. The namespace tells LangGraph where to store the memories within its underlying long-term memory store. Since the store is shared across the entire graph, if you have multiple agents, you may want to organize them with separate memories. Or if you want to save memories pertaining to different users, you can save these under their own unique namespaces. After fixing our model name, let's rerun the scenario from before. The agent tells us that it saved the plan to memory. Let's double check to see. Let's check LangSmith to observe a few things. First, let's see what the tools actually look like from the perspective of the agent. We see we've provided the two tools, manage memory and search memory. In this case, it first searches the memory. We see that this tool allows it to filter, limit, offset, but primarily generate a particular query in order to search its memories. Here we can see that it's looking up half marathon training plan, just to check to make sure that it doesn't have additional memories it should be consulting before updating anything. After searching its memory, the agent then decides to manage the memory. Here we see what the tool looks like again to the LLM. Let's check the manage memory tool this time from the perspective of the LLM. We see it contains its own set of instructions on when it should be used, and it allows the LLM to pick one of the actions for creating, updating, or deleting memories. Depending on the action, it can decide to provide content for creations and updates, or the ID for updates or deletions. In this case, it's decided to create a new memory. If I start a new thread, asking some ambiguous context that would ask it to jog its memory, it looks it up for us. You can confirm in LangSmith that it had to search for this memory. If you follow the trajectory of the agent, you see this is the first message that it receives, and it has to search its memory to get more contextual information. It then sees those results and responds saying exactly where we're supposed to be. If we provide information that conflicts with old memories or causes it to update it, we can see that the agent is able to, again, use the manage memory tool in order to update its memories. If we check the corresponding trace in LangSmith, we see the LLM first calls the search memory tool to look at existing memories and then decides to manage again to update that memory based on IT. It then commits this modified plan to accommodate the injury and saves that to memory. This overwrites the previous memory to ensure that everything that it is able to search remains valid. Up to this point, the agent has been saving memories all within the same namespace, the agent memories namespace, because we created that here. If your agent supports multiple users, you'll likely want to make sure that the memories remain separate so that you don't leak information between interactions. To do so, add a template variable to your namespace. LangMem interprets this as a value that needs to be populated at runtime from your configurable dictionary. We will recreate the agent and modify our little chat helper here to accommodate a new user ID. If I first chat using user A, it'll save those memories to its own namespace. If I then interact with the same agent as user B, it will manage memories that don't conflict and doesn't have access to the memories from user A. You can check that it doesn't have any overlap by actually interrogating the model from the perspective of user ID 2, or for more confidence, you can directly search the store. Here you can see memories for user A stored about user Will and is doing a half marathon training, and then user B is learning chess and wants to improve. Since these are each in separate namespaces, the agent is not able to access ones whenever it's configured to a different user. If you recall from the agent trace, these tools don't even have a namespace parameter. It's all transparent to the agent itself, since the agent just operates on the level of IDs and content. Behind the scenes, the tool itself is looking at the configuration that you as the developer have set and will be placing memories in the correct location accordingly. If you're paying attention, you'll notice that the agent actually has to actively decide in order to search its memories. Let's change that. We're going to add an initial search step that looks over memories based on the incoming context before calling the LLM. This lets the LLM have some information about the conversation before it has to go and decide anything. It means that it might even save a tool call or two because it might already be in context. What we're going to do is in here, we will add a search over memories, and then we'll add it into a system prompt so that we can instruct the LLM to respond, taking into account everything that it remembers. We'll fetch the store from context and use the content of the most recent message to search for relevant memories. This is a quick heuristic. You might want to include the context from the last human message in case there's other tool messages coming in, or you might want to include more conversational context in trying to generate the query. Now that we've created our new agent, let's run our simulation again. This time it ran much faster, and we can confirm with the LangSmith trace. If you look at the new agent trajectory, you can see this additional prompt step that takes it in and returns all of the memories here, all dumped into the string. In this case, the AI still decided to search again in case there's additional memories, which again speaks to the trade-offs of even exposing this at all, but it had enough information from that default contextual lookup so that if it wanted to, it could respond in the first try. So that's all for today. In this video, we built an agent that's able to manually manage its own semantic memory. This lets it store important facts and other information and use them in later conversations. For more information about other memory types, and for more information about the conceptual framing behind LangMem, check out the concept videos or the LangMem docs. See you next time.